What I'm worried about now isn't a second surge. I'm worried about the continuation of the first one into the indefinite future. Maybe a nice analogy for what I'm sensing is going on in the community is that we're in a hurricane and the first wall has gone through and now we're in the eye of the storm and we have this sense of, well, it's over, but there's the back wall that's about to hit us and that has more force and power than the front wall did. That's what we have to brace ourselves for, because in my opinion, it's coming for us right now and we have to be ready and we have to be smart. Well, social distancing can work under certain circumstances, but right now, I have to say I'm very concerned about where we are as a state and where we are as a country. We were headed towards flattening, and in Alabama, we're doing okay, but a lot of other states in the country are still having an exponential growth. This is not the time to relax the constraints or the stay-at-home orders until we get a little bit more control of the epidemic. And what I'm very worried about is that a new projection came out just yesterday that showed up to 200,000 new cases a day could be transmitted by June 1st. And to put that in perspective, the highest number we've ever had was on April 24th, where there were 37,000 new cases a day. This is where we're heading if we just abandon all caution and jump into the deep end with both feet. We have to be very smart about this. The virus doesn't care what our political stripes are. It doesn't care whether we're at a restaurant or whether we're at a social gathering. It just wants to infect people. And most of us are susceptible. So we have to gain control of the virus by our behavior and what we do. That's what we have control of. I fully understand and appreciate that people are suffering. I mean, this is not normal. This is far from it. Businesses are closed. People are going without jobs. And sometimes even food is difficult to find for people who have lost their jobs. I get it. And I think that me more than anyone, I would like to see us get back to normal. But I also know that if we do this too quickly in a way that's not constrained and that's not smart, we're going to be 10 to 100 times worse in a month or two than we are even now. So for folks at home right now, this is a scary time. Everyone's getting information from multiple sources. And unfortunately, a lot of it is filtered through a political lens or depending on what news you're watching. Here's what we should do. Be patient. Be resolute. We know what we can do to protect ourselves. Wearing a mask anytime we're outside, making sure that we wash our hands frequently and well. Try not to be around others unless it really is essential, and especially protecting older folks. One of the hardest things in this epidemic is seeing parents and grandparents in facilities, like even if they're totally functional, but they're at a home for seniors. We can't visit, but we shouldn't, because we hear right now one of the hot spots around the country are nursing homes and senior facilities, and they're at the highest risk of dying. And then finally, be good citizens, be patriots. By following the rules, knowing what's important, knowing about keeping our distance and protecting ourselves and our family, we're therefore protecting our community against this accelerated progression of new cases. And that's essential for us into the future.